For me, coaching is a relationship with purpose. And that purpose is to listen, to ask questions, and to identify next steps to help the person who's being coached go to where the Holy Spirit is leading them to. Ministry coaching to me is analogous to the headlights on a car. You drive a car at night, the headlights give you what? About 100 feet, 150 feet in front of you. The destination may be 30, 50 miles away, but if you trust the incremental step in front of you, the headlight, eventually it's going to get you to the destination. And that is why coaching is vastly different from mentoring or consultancy or counseling, for instance. Counseling and mentoring often look backwards for good reason and for helpful reasons. In coaching, you're always looking forward. In other words, going back to the car, you're always looking through the windshield as you go forward. So a coaching relationship, a session may sound something like this. Let's say Ted wanted to be a church planter and he knows he wants some coaching. So he calls me up and he says, "Anthony, I want to be a church planter. Will you coach me? I'd be happy to." "Ted, tell me what you know about church planting." He said, "Well, I've read a book from Ed Stetzer. I've gone to a conference. That's about what I know, but I know I'm excited and I want to do this." "Okay, that's a start, Ted. So can you see any gaps right now in your education or know-how that need to be filled?" "Well, yeah, from what I understand, to be a church planter, I have to be an excellent gatherer of people, and I don't know a lot about that. I've got no money. I need to know how to fundraise." "Okay, Ted, do you know anybody who has experience in this way that you can talk to that might help you get there?" "Oh, yeah, I know this guy, Heber Tekus, man. That guy knows everything about church planting. He's done it. He knows his stuff." "Okay, Ted, we're going to talk again in 3 weeks. Between now and the time we get back together, would you be willing to call Heber? And if so, what will you talk to him about?" "Well, yeah, I will call him." "Ted, is there any obstacle or hindrance that would keep you from making that call?" "Well, yeah, I'm intimidated by Heber. You know, he knows so much. I don't know if I..." "Boy, he's pretty fired up. I don't know if I'm ready for that. But okay, so what are some steps we can do to hold you accountable?" "Here's what I'll do." This is Ted talking. "I'll call him on Wednesday, and I want you as my coach to follow up on Thursday with an email to make sure I place that call, and then I'll tell you all about it the next time we gather for a coaching session." Now, by Ted talking to Heber, is he suddenly going to be a church planter? No. No. But by him talking to Heber, did he take that incremental step forward? Yes, he did. And that is what coaching is. It's always taking step forward to get to where the Spirit is leading. Always moving forward. And coaching often is helping people do the challenging things they might not want to do on their own. If you've had a coach ever growing up in sports, you remember this, don't you? "I play basketball, but I can tell you I loathed running those wind sprints." You know what I'm talking about? They call them suicides. I mean, that should tell you something right there. But by running those wind sprints over and over, day after day, and having the accumulative effect of that, what happened the next time I played in a game? Suddenly, I didn't get winded as quickly. I wasn't as much of a coward when fatigue started to set in. And I really appreciated the fact the coach had me do that challenging thing that maybe I would not have done on my own if he had not challenged me to do so. Do you see that? So a coach does the same thing. And so I believe in it so much, and I've gained so much value from it. I can't imagine now in my career in ministry that I won't have a coach. Would you have benefit of having a coach? Because that's what the coaching services are here to do, to come alongside you, to help you. This is available to all of us. So we've lined up not only myself, but other coaches who I think are uniquely gifted to do this, and they want to help. I would love to see that this coaching becomes part of the DNA of who we are.